What's up, YouTube? This is Coach Chaney, man, coming at you with another video. Hope you guys are having a great week of practice, a great week of preparation. But what I want to talk about today is, how are positions determined? How does a young man come in who's new to high school football? How do you pick a position? How does your coach pick a position for you? All right, let's get into it. Hey, this is Coach Chaney with Football Recruiting and Life, coming to you with another video. Make sure you hit my subscribe button, man, and smash that like button on the video. Hit the notification button. You know, it really helps us get the word out. Lately, I've been getting a lot of inquiries and a lot of comments regarding, hey, coach, how do I play a certain position? How do I pick a position? I'm this size or I'm that size, and what position should I play? What position should I go out for? That is a very complicated question. It's a question that has a lot of layers to it, and let me try to unpeel a few, and I'm not going to be here long today, but let me try to unpeel a few of those layers. When you, some kids, and this doesn't go for all kids, but the philosophy I like to go for is, I like for a kid to play a position that he'll translate to as a college football player, okay? So if you come in as a freshman and you're 6'3", 250, and you tell me, hey, coach, I want to play running back, 9 times out of 10, I'm going to try to steer you to being an offensive, defensive lineman, because at 6'3", 250, as a freshman, you probably grow to 6'4", 290, and you won't be playing running back at that size, all right? So nothing against you. Nobody's trying to doubt your talent and doubt what you do, but those are things that, as an adult, as an experienced football coach, we try to steer you in the right direction if that's your goal to play college football, okay? So that's number one. Number two, notice when we start football practice, we start with a bunch of drills. Bunch of agility drills, bunch of cone drills, bag drills, running drills. We kind of want to see what your agility is. We want to see what your quickness is. We want to see how athletic you are. And that kind of determines whether you're going to be a skill guy or whether you're going to be a offensive, defensive lineman. You know, skill guys, quarterbacks, running backs, wide receivers, fullbacks, tight ends, those guys have to be able to move in space, and they have to have ball skills to be able to catch footballs and things of that nature. So a lot of times, players will come in and say and think that those drills are just like a punishment type of thing. Oh, they just do that because every other coach does it. No, we do those skill drills to evaluate you, to try to fit you into the best position that helps the football team. All right, so that's number two, okay? Number three, some kids may come in and they have an extensive Pop Warner career. They played a certain position. They match the size requirements to play that position. They match the athletic requirements to play that position. So it's a natural fit. You know, we kind of talk to players and say, hey, man, who'd you play youth football for? Oh, I played for so-and-so. You know, I played, you know, this position and that position. And those kids are familiar with the ins and outs and the technique of that position. So that's more of an easier, natural fit. You know, even sometimes with those kids, we will kind of put them in a position that may best suit them or may best suit the team, okay? So positions, I mean, it could definitely change from year to year. It can change from youth football to high school football. It can even change from high school to college, all right? But what I want to kind of bring home with this video, I'm kind of giving you an idea of what we're thinking as a head football coach, as position coaches. I'm kind of letting you in our mindset of how we help kids pick positions. And at the end of the day, you can pretty much play any position you want, and you can try for any position you want. But what we want you to do, we want you to be successful. We want you to be on the field. If a certain position doesn't fit you, if it doesn't fit your skill set, we shouldn't allow you to play that position because it's a hard fit. You won't get on the field. You can't get in the starting lineup. We want you to be in the starting lineup. And as you saw in my video in the past, the number one thing that I always thought as an athlete is I want to be on the field. I want to play. I'm not going to sit and wait for 3 years behind somebody at a certain position that I thought was glamorous, that I thought I wanted to have. I want to get on the field. I want to get on the field as quickly as possible. So I'm willing to play any position that'll help my team, and I'm going to be a little selfish. I'm willing to pay any position that'll get me on the field first, all right? So for all you guys who have dreams of being recruited, for all you guys who have dreams of playing college football, the coach is going to see you on the film if you excel, no matter what the position is. And we got to let the college football coach figure out what position best suits their needs for you as a college player. There's a lot of kids that get recruited who say they're a quarterback in high school. They may recruit them as a DB. Or, you know, say they're a big wide receiver in high school. They may be a defensive end or outside linebacker in college. Who cares what position you play? I mean, if you're getting a free education, who cares what position? I mean, and that's how I think about it. And I know people have a little more, want to when it comes to positions. But, man, my thing is you're playing the game you love. You're playing a sport. I don't feel like you should really lock yourself into one position. I think you should play multiple positions. I think you should know multiple positions. And I think that you'll be recruited as a college player based on your effort, intensity, how you dominate the game, and they'll figure out what position that you need to play. Like, a college scout can see your film and say, man, that kid's the best kid on the field, but I don't want him on my team because he's not playing wide receiver. That ain't how it works. They want the best available athletes on their squad. They want guys who are going to play the position and who are going to give them effort and going to be intense. You know what I'm saying? So always understand that, number one, you know, you want to try to get on the field. So okay. Remember, get on the field, man. I mean, don't let your pride stand in the way of you playing football and getting on the field and getting some minutes, man. You know, we struggle with that as youngsters. And it's cool, I understand. We struggle with numbers. Oh, coach, I wore number 9. My daddy played in number 9. And number 9 means so much to me and all that type of stuff, man. No, look, man, you make the number. The number doesn't make you, and I'll make a whole other video about that. But positions are important, and, you know, it's okay to want to be a skilled guy, but there's only one football, one football, and we can't all have that football. So get on the field, man. Enjoy the game. Play the game, and the rest of all that stuff will come. But I hope I kind of answered that looming question of, coach, what position should I play? Or coach, how do you guys pick positions? And, you know, be willing to be flexible, man, and change throughout the year. You know, you may start out as a tight end at the first half of the year, and somebody gets hurt at offensive tackle, you may have to play tackle. It's the same thing. You're blocking. One thing you can't do as a tackle that you could do as a tight end is run out for passes. You have to change your number. But you're on the field, man. You're playing football. That's all that matters. You'll be able to watch that film on Huddle for the rest of your life. So if you guys have any questions, man, leave a comment below. I hope I answered your questions to the best of my ability. And I hope that your mindset guides you and motivates you to get on the field. Get on the field, man. Don't worry about it. It's so fun playing out there. It don't matter what position you play. It is so enjoyable going out there and knocking heads with guys and being on the field and being able to contribute to your team's success. So that's what I'm talking about, man. If you have any specific questions, comment below. Make sure you hit the subscribe button, hit the notification button. Let's get this information to all these young guys out here who want to play the game. I appreciate you guys following my channel, subscribing, and hitting the notification button, man, and the questions. I love them. I try to answer them as quickly as possible. And, man, stay tuned for my next video. I don't know what it's going to be about, but something, you know, I kind of let stuff inspire me, and then I talk about it. But I hope you guys are enjoying the channel, man. Subscribe. You guys have a great rest of the week in football. I hope that your season starts on time. If it doesn't, you just keep training, keep getting better. Things will work out with no problem. Hey, this is Coach Chaney, Football Recruiting and Life, man. Y'all have a great week. Talk to you later.